Hey everyone, how are you doing? You have Mike here, and today we are looking at the ViparSpectra 600 watt LED grow light. So I've actually been playing with this light now for a couple of days, and I got to admit, I'm actually a little bit impressed. So I'm going to manhandle a little bit here, kind of toss it around, and we're going to show you a couple things. So as you can see on the front, it does have a little LCD display right here, which is actually pretty cool. I haven't seen too many other grow lights that have a display like this. It really allows you to set your time. And like I said, this here is the TC model. So this is a timer control. So you don't need any more timers or anything like this. This light here, you can program it and it's just gonna do everything for you. So one thing that I really wanted to take note is this light is pretty heavy. It's got a pretty big chunk of aluminum in there. And as you can see at the top, there is two pretty big fans. So I can tell you that when this light is running, the fans actually do push quite a bit of air. I can feel it blowing in my grow tent here. So pretty impressive with how much air they can actually push. So the next thing that I wanted to show, and what I'm going to do, is put up a little chart on the screen so you can see the visual spectrum of light. So it actually goes from 400 nanometers all the way up to 700 nanometers. So what I want to cover here in this is that this light here is actually a 12 band full spectrum dimmable light. So it actually has purple. You can see it goes from the deep purple down to 440 nanometers all the way up to 660 nanometers, which is your deep reds. And then it also has, at 730 nanometers, it has the infrared. It also has two bands of 3000K and 7500K lighting. So it really kind of does cover the whole band of spectrum of light. Okay, so I do want to point out that the four LEDs that look dim are the IRs, and you won't really pick those up on camera, and they look pretty dim to the human eye. But those are the IRs, and that's why they are dim. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hang this up and we're going to talk a little bit more about it. All right, so now that we got the ViparSpectra 600 inside the grow tent, what we're going to do is talk a little bit about the coverage of the light and why we kind of chose it. Now, obviously, our grow tent was a big factor in this. It's a 3x3 grow tent, so we wanted to make sure that our light was going to have at least a 3x3 coverage. So 2.5 at 2.5 at 20 inches above the plants, and with the veg, it's at 28 inches 3x3 coverage. So we should be all right with that in here. Another thing that I really liked about it was the having a USA customer service and warranty department. So you're not sending these lights back overseas. Everything's done here in North America, which is absolutely awesome. And something that I'm definitely looking for when I'm buying a light. So what I would kind of like to do here now is kind of take the light. We're going to center it into our tent a little bit, and we're going to pull out our PAR meter. Now I have a PAR meter here by Apogee, and as you can see, it is just kind of tucked away here. But this is a Apogee PAR meter, it's very similar to the one that was used in order to get the PAR results that you see up on the screen here, that ViparSpectra owns. The only difference is mine is a full spectrum reader, which means just a little bit better, maybe about double the price as theirs. So I'm going to get this started here, and what we're going to do is we're going to check the wattage that the light is pulling and also the PAR ratings. Alright, so I have my Apogee PAR meter here off to the side, which I know you guys can't really see on camera. But what we're going to do is we're going to do a quick test. Now, as you can see on the screen, they did it from 24, they did a measurement from 24 inches directly under the light. And that's what we're going to replicate this in this here little test. And put that under the middle. Oh, my reader just turned off. Nothing is easy. So I'm getting a reading here of 590, 99, 604. I'm getting a reading of 612. 612. 610, 611, 612. So since my meter was designed for underwater use, I actually have to divide that by 1.3 to get the actual reading. So I'm going to come and do that right now because I can't do that off the top of my head. So since we have this layer, I'll show you the different channels, the veg and bloom, since I'm already here and I got the camera set up. So this here, just on blue, is actually on 100% veg. And as you can see, I can either drop it down with my remote by dropping it down, or I have the option of just turning it down here. And it makes your light dimmable, so you can really have complete control over your grill. So I find that really useful and really cool, and I really do like the display that it has on it. So I'm just gonna set this back, turn this right off. I'm going to change a different channel, and I wanna show you the bloom. So the bloom's got this beautiful pinkish look to it. Now, if I turn this back on to channel one and I turn this on here, so now it's got both bloom and veg on, you can see that it's actually a beautiful white light, cancels each other out. The blue and the red makes a beautiful white light. And this is what you'd want to grow your plants with. So this here is, like I said, I find this light to be a really nice and beautiful light. All right, guys, so what we're going to do here is I'm going to show you how to set the clock and how to program it, because it's very easy to program. So as you see the clock, we can set it to the time. Right now, it's actually 2:33, so the clock is set. You just set your time, you press OK for the 14, boom. Now on, there's a button on the remote that says on, and you want to turn on at 14:35, and we're going to turn it off at 14:36. Because why not? Just for the purpose of this video. And then now, boom, that is set. This is the easiest light that I've ever seen to program. It's very simple. Okay, so it took a little while, but I did figure out why my readings were a little bit higher than the readings of ViparSpectra's that you see here on the screen. Now, they were showing directly under the light that they were getting a PAR of about 364. So I was actually getting a reading of 611, but I have to divide my reading by 1.32, and that gives me a PAR of 463. So that is actually much higher than the readings that we are getting right from the manufacturer. So this actually did took me to a little bit of research, and I just found out that it was actually just with the meter that they have. Now they're using a really high quality Apogee meter. It's probably about a $300 meter, which is, it's pretty high quality. It's not quite like the one that we have. It's not a full spectrum meter. And that's the big key point here. So remember what at the beginning of the video, we were talking about the LEDs that it used, and how that it did use the deep red, which was 660 nanometers. Well, it turns out that the meter that they are using stops reading at about 655, so it won't actually see the deep red LEDs. So my reader that does, my reader goes from 389 nanometers all the way up to 692, so it can see that deep red, and that is why the ratings are a little bit higher. So actually, you are getting more than what you paid for with this light, which is pretty awesome. Now, including of running these tests on the lights, we also did run the voltage test to check out how much wattage the lights were using, and it actually did show up as 269 to 270 watts, exactly what is stated on the website. So once again, the lived up to their name, and they're actually quite honest with the results and everything. So I'm really happy with this light, and really happy about this purchase. Now, if you would like to see me do a full mapping of the PAR, just let me know in the comments, and maybe that's something we can do in a future video to kind of update the map, because as you know, since the PAR meter that they had doesn't really cover the full deep reds, there's no real accurate PAR map right now for these lights. But I did notice that pretty much all the lights that they use these deep reds. So all these lights, you're getting a little bit more than what you paid for, which is pretty awesome, like it was saying. So I would like to thank everybody for watching, and I hope you guys all have yourself a great day.